Hello everyone, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, good day. Hope you're all having a good one. Welcome back to GTA 5. Today, well, in the previous video we did this, and I don't think it could be beaten. I think this is probably the best lowrider I've made so far. But right behind me, you can see we have the Primo. Now, this is a car I wasn't expecting to be able to modify in this, because it's like a sedan car. It's just your standard sort of four-door family sedan, and not the sort of old classic, like, 70s car from America that you would expect to see as a lowrider. So this is quite exciting for me. I'm quite curious to see what there is. Here's some comments right now on screen. If you want your comment in the comment section, if you want to have a comment in the next video, sorry, leave it in the comment section below, and I'll pick a couple at random. So there we go. Let's jump into Benny's and modify this thing. So I haven't actually done a like counter for any of these lowrider videos. So let's see if we can try and hit 20 likes. I think we can hit that. That's a pretty fair number. I think that's good. Okay, so let's start with upgrading the vehicle, of course, and it gives us this. I love how it looks already. Like, just that with these wheels looks fantastic. But we want to make it proper unique to us. I don't know if anyone's going to make these cars anywhere like how I'm doing them. If anyone makes a car similar to me in a video, I would love to know. I don't know. I always think that I try to make these cars as unique as possible. Even if I don't like them, I just want to make them unique. So that's my goal. Okay, right. Let's get a front bumper. And we've got a bunch of nulls here. What do they do? We've got one that smooths it. That's quite cool. Very Euro style. We've got one that... Oh, it's like the standard one, but it removes the number plate. Oh, I like that. Oh, I like that indeed. Or we've got a smooth one. Or we've got smooth with a textured thing. Oh, that's probably a bit too garish. I know. I think I might play it safe with this one and go for this one. I quite like it. It's sort of standard, but not because you're removing the number plate. I quite like that. It'd be nice if we could have the ability to remove number plates on more cars, actually. Because I quite like the look without number plates on a lot of cars. What have we got for the rear bumper? We've got smoothed side repeaters. I quite like that because it's got the chrome in it as well. No, I want to keep them. I want to... sod it. We've got them on the front. We'll get rid of them on the back. Okay. Exhausts, we've got that. We've got the chrome tip, the big bore, the titanium, I hate those ones, and the engraved. Oh man, that's crazy. Look at the detail in that. I don't want to go for the crazy detail in this one. Or do I? Oh, sod it. Let's just go for that one. Let's get a front bumper and make it that one. Let's just go crazy, okay? Right, skirts. What have we got for skirts? It's debadging. Okay, right, let's get rid of the debadging. Or let's debadge it, rather. Does that debadge it on the front? It does not. Grill. Maybe this one would debadge it. Nope. We've got that one that sort of gets... I quite like the standard one, though. Okay, that makes you have less grills. That one, which just slightly spaces them out differently. I don't like that one at all. Mesh grill? That kind of fits. Black grill, which is sort of mesh with things on the front. And, okay, yeah. We're going to go all out. Let's just go all out right here. Let's go for the hood. Remove hood, latch cover, or glass? I think remove hood with the latch cover. I think that's very sort of show car style-y. Let's make this the sort of thing where you would never see it on the road. This is the sort of thing you would see at a car show. Let's make it like that. Spoilers, we've got a low level and a high level. I don't think they really suit what we've got planned here. Oh, I just noticed the low level one has a supercharged V8 badge up here. Interesting. Let's turn them off. I don't want to spoil it. I think it will spoil it. Okay. Plaques. Right. Do we always have to have plaques in these? I kind of feel like it's getting a bit cliche. So, let's not go for one. Let's not have a plaque in this one. I'm just going to say it right here. No plaques in this car. Speakers. This is where we're going right now. Small, custom. Okay, that looks terrible. That's quite nice. That's quite nice and simple. And also the subs are feeding into the cabin. Something which I'm keen to notice, because also with a lot of these designs, like this one, you're not going to hear that inside the car. Let's be honest. It's like the whole boot compartment is blocked off from the cabin. You're not going to hear that anywhere near as good as, say, that. And, like, having the airflow going into the cabin of all the bass. Because if you're obstructing airflow, you're not going to get the bass in the cabin. So these look good, but they're not going to sound good. But then I did say this is going to be a show car and not something you're going to use on the road. So let's go for that one, of course. Hydraulics, what have we got? We've got your standard painted pump. We've got... Oh, this one's going to continue with the floor color. So we're going to stick with that one. And that one's too big. I quite like that one with sort of the batteries sort of flush in the floor under some glass. That's very show car styly, so we'll go with that one. Tank. What can we do? This doesn't really change anything. So we'll keep that as none. I still don't understand what that tank's supposed to be, really. But I can't see any difference on that. So I don't know. I haven't played this online, so I don't know what that's supposed to be. Livery. We've got some pinstripes. Basic pinstripes. I want to go all out. So let's go further along this list and see what we've got here. Okay, these are looking pretty good so far. But oh no. Oh yeah. This is what we want. Look at that. Oh, I like that in that color. I like that with black on the top, actually, as well. I mean, that black was supposed to be just the standard color, but that kind of goes. Black and burgundy. Who would have thought that? Okay, we'll try some other colors, but I think that black might be the one. Aerials. Okay, there's an aerial on that side. It gets rid of it. You can add some bigger antennas, some classic style 90s ones with, like, your in-car phone. Let's go for that one. Let's go for the in-car phone aerials that you used to have back in the day. Painted wipers. Secondary painted wipers, chrome. Let's go for chrome. Otherwise, it's going to get a bit too mad right here. Engine. Okay, this is where... Okay, that's just the thing. We don't want to upgrade that. Engine block. Here we go. Holy crap. Look at the changes on that. Okay, that is amazing. And I quite like it with that, actually. I prefer that to just showing the bare rocker cover. Although, I quite like the engraved chrome covers. But... Ah, we've got to go for that one. Got to go for that one. And air filters, we've got chrome, twin, swept-back, engraved, and a turbo. That's nice, but I'm going to go for engraved because I want to make this a completely sort of mad lowrider show car right here. Completely not what you would expect from this sort of car, but that's why it's fun. That's why it's exciting. Interior, we'll leave to last. Of course, always leave the best till last. Number plates holder. Let's go for a magnet. Magnetex one, whatever it's called. What's it called? Magnetics. Wow, I can't read. Yankton. Of course, I do like Yankton plates. I don't know why. This is a slightly off color. They're kind of cool looking. Probably because you don't see them much in the game. And we don't need a vanity plate because... Oh, we can add one, though. We can add one, but I don't want to. I don't want to. Let's leave that on none. Lights. Neon. Oh, should we go for a neon this time? Let's actually... Maybe this will be the only car we do in neon, so let's just do neons, okay? And maybe we'll go for antique white. That's kind of... Yeah, because it's like on show cars, you always get like the lights that they stick under the cars anyway just to show them off, so we'll do that. Okay, that'll work. Window tints. Ooh, proper black. I kind of like that, but I'd like to see inside the interior, so let's just do a light smoke. Okay, respray. Here we go. So... Yeah, I kind of like this in black. Let's just run through and see what the rest of the colors look like. But I have a feeling that it's not going to be beaten. Although I quite like that. Although I don't like how that looks around the lights. That looks pretty horrible right there. Or we could have it in a similar color, but then you won't see all the details. Nah, these look horrible. These look really, really horrible. I don't like any of those. What about cream, beige? No. We've done beige before. Let's just change this up right here. To black. I like the black. Well, I just noticed it actually changes the color of the thing as well. Ah, that's cool. Let's go for black. It looks great. Let's go for black 2. Black 2. Perfect. But a secondary color change. Ah, it changes the interior seats. I don't know what color we're going to go for that. So let's leave that for now and change. Oh, the wheels first, then the interior. But I have a feeling that we're going to go for the standard wheels here because they're going to be a lot smaller, aren't they? I mean, those ones are bigger, but these ones don't look as good. Oh, mind you, these suit this car more, I'd say. I mean, I don't like them, but they sort of suit the car more. Oh, man. I do love these big bar things. They are proper donk wheels. Sod it. Let's go for it. Tires. White walls as well. Let's just go mental. This is going to look horrible, but who cares? Who cares? Bluish silver, brighten them up a bit. Although red, I've seen them with like a red in the middle. Oh no, it changes that bit. Not the interior bit. Nah. I'm thinking maybe if there's a color that's similar to the body. Let's go for that one. Let's see if there's any other wheels that sort of change that sort of style as well. Oh no. Okay, no, they're not right. Although that one. Oh, let's go for these, actually. They're a lot better. I like those. They're very 90s style. Let's go for those. And we need to get rid of this blue interior pronto. So let's change the interior up. Trim. Design. Oh, wow. This matches it all. Oh, wow. Okay, so we've got that one with neons. And then some extreme interior. Oh, my God. It completely gets rid of that middle seat in the back and adds speakers. Okay, we're going to go for that one with some neon. That looks so, so cool. And should we just go for a proper, like, dark interior on this one? Anthracite, grey, black. Let's do it. Let's just go for black. This is going to be a proper blacked out interior, as I don't think I'm going to do that again. Ornaments. Should we go for... I don't really like the bobbleheads. I don't like the bobbleheads at all, so we're not going to go for them. Steering wheels. I quite like the three-way. What other ones do we have here? I do like the chain link steering wheels. I wonder what they're like to drive in real life. I'm very curious, especially with a car that doesn't have power steering. As I imagine a lot of these older cars probably wouldn't have. It'd be kind of fun. Column shifter. Seems we don't have a gear stick anymore. Of course. Let's go for the 8-ball to go for the black, maybe. What else do we have? We've got... Oh, actually. Gem. Let's go for the gem. Ice. What's that going to do? We've got... Oh, look. Behind. On the parcel shelf. Okay. Yeah. That one. Perfect. And light color. We're going to change to... White? White's kind of too similar to the subwoofers. Red. What about a dark red? Let's go for that one, see what it looks like from the outside. Okay, this thing is baller. Look at this. That's it all done, I think. Let's go drive this outside and check it out. Oh, man. That is cool. That is seriously cool. I like it. I kind of like it. I wouldn't have it in real life, but I like the overall creation. It's interesting. It's different. Oh, man. That's pretty amazing. Right, let's actually... In fact, I got out, but let's actually get back in. And first of all, obligatory playing with the hydraulics. I love just doing basic hops on the front. Just do a back hop this time. Still can't figure out freewheeling. Still can't figure it out. I have no idea what I'm doing. Can't get it. No, it's just... You can't... None of the wheels, like, stick up in the air. Oh, man, this is close to toppling over. Right, okay, let's go to vehicles, let's go to fix, let's go to clean, and let's go to door control and open everything up right here. Oh yeah, we haven't got a hood. I was thinking, why is it going up? We haven't got a hood, that's why. Open the rear doors, front doors, and let's settle down the hydraulics as well. Oh man, this is looking pretty beautiful. Let's get out, have a look. Oh crap, God's sake, Michael. Look around. Oh, look at this. This is proper cool. I would not have this car in real life. I would definitely not do this if I owned this car in real life and I had the money to do this. I would definitely do something else. But this looked pretty cool as a show car. And that was the goal. I think that's pretty good. If you guys actually like what I build, let me know. Because I'm used to seeing more people criticizing the cars I make when I modify cars in GTA. So it'd be nice to see anyone who agrees and thinks that it's cool, even if you probably wouldn't do it yourself. So there we go, guys. That is it. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye!